Nobody knows how long this wait will be. Many of the migrants who remain are families. Some have small children. They're camped out and waiting. Under international law, the U.S. has to at least consider their claims for amnesty at some point, but when that point will be isn't clear.
That is ABC's Alex Stone at the U.S.-Mexican border. Nearly 200 Central American migrants attempting to seek asylum in the U.S. stopped in their tracks. They're not being allowed into this country, but at some point they're going to at least have to have their
cases heard,
reviewed,
sure.
Their cases heard. C4, what to do about them?
Well, let me tell you something. This is an annual event, which, by the way, I wasn't aware of, that apparently there's an organization in Central and South America that gets either Honduras, Chile, El Salvador. They bring about 1,500, maybe this is the largest one, but 1,500 down to 1,000 every single year on this caravan. It's an attempt to show at least the fact that the United States should pay more attention to some of the ongoing things on the ground in these countries where you really have horrific. Look, there's no... The horrific conditions are on the ground when it comes to violence, when it comes to gang activity.
There's
the rest
no
of
question there's justification for them to leave their home countries.
Absolutely, but there's a process, Robert. And the problem is that you have organizations like the ones been sponsoring this annually that want to avoid the regulatory requirements for asylum, for coming in as refugees. And we can't do that. If the signal is sent, like President Ronald Reagan did in 1986, that will give amnesty to individuals. And it came from a lot of terrible situations. That opens the door for others who don't necessarily come from those situations to use that same pattern to get entry into the United States.
As President Trump stressed, it's the law that's messed up.
It is the law. And that's why Congress, and that's why the abdication of a Republican House and a Republican Senate, because they control both, to really make this issue of immigration and immigration reform first and foremost on the table. You have the Supreme Court case right now where President Trump, if they rule the way we think in June, will have the power as the executive when it comes to refugees and this whole process we see in place. But right now, it's not the United States' fault in this situation to me in terms of stopping at the border. This is what the law prescribes.
So you just leave these people at the
border? No, absolutely. Was Mexico? No, how come no one is asking the question about Mexico's responsibility? They have traveled for a month, mainly through Mexico to get here. Why hasn't Mexico been more affordable to these individuals and helped them more than the United States? Mexico has seen this every single year through their country this march to the United States border. And that's why President Trump is talking about using NAFTA, the North American Free Trade Agreement, to punish Mexico for, you know, these people are being, in some instances, molested or there's horrible things happen to them on this trek. Why isn't Mexico more involved in stopping these horrors and abuses?
But at the same time, they want to go to the U.S. They don't want to stay in Mexico.
I understand. But once again, a lot of people want a whole lot of things, but there's a process involved with how you get it. If you avoid the process, I'm going to say again, Robert, you open the door for people who aren't necessarily refugees in a situation or leaving horrific situations. That's why I blame these other countries for forcing this situation to be met at the border. They didn't have to do this. There could have been a whole way of dealing with this on the way to assess these individuals.
I can't imagine there's ever going to be immigration reform getting through Congress.
But that's, once again, that's elected officials' problem. You just because you can't get it, but just because you can't get it done, that means that you violate the current rules that are in existence.
All right, C4 Encore tonight
at
midnight, and back tomorrow 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.